Hello students, myself Anurag Goel from Vidyamandir Classes. Today we are going to discuss matrices and determinants, questions from actual JEE advanced papers from 2013 to 18. Okay, let's look at this question. It is from 2018 advanced paper. It says set S be the set of all column matrices consisting of real elements such that the system of equations given like this has at least one solution. Okay, then which of the following system also has at least one solution for all set of column matrices in S? Okay, now let's look at this on board. The given system is, you may write it in matrix form as -1, 2, 5, 2, -4, 3, 1, -2, 2, x, y, z, b1, b2, b3. It is your known matrix, this is unknown matrix, and this is your known matrix. It says the given system has at least one real solution, at least one solution. The system has at least one solution, that is, it has at least one set of x, y, z which satisfies this. And set S consists of all column matrices b1, b2, b3, such that the system Ax is equal to b has at least one solution. We need to find this set and then further. Okay, now let's compute the determinant of the coefficient matrix. Determinant A will be -1, -8, +3, 5, -2, 4, -3, 1, +5, -4, +4, 0. It comes out to be -2. It is 0. Determinant of A is 0. Hence, either the system has no solution or it has infinitely many solutions. But according to the question, the given system, it has either no solution or has infinitely many solutions. But according to the question, it says it has at least one solution. It means it has infinitely many solutions. That means the three rows are, the three equation of planes are linearly dependent. That is one of them is linear combination of the other two. Okay, infinitely many solution is also the case when the planes are coincident. But in this case, you can see clearly, say if this is, let's say, R1, this is row 2, this is your row 3, the three rows are linearly independent. That is, this row is not twice of this, it is similarly this. And we have infinitely many solution of this system. That means let's write this third as, that is, x - 2y + 2z is equal to b3. This must be linear combination of the other two, because it has infinitely many solution and there is no case of coincident plane. That means if we have first plane as this equation, second as this equation, the third must be passing through the same line of intersection. That means this plane 3 must be something like λp1 + μp2. This is the scenario, and we have this is also unknown. We must write this equation for in these three rows. That is, 1 - 2, 2 must be lambda times -1, 2, 5 + μ times 2, -4, 3. That makes equations as -λ + 2μ as 1, 2λ - 4μ as -2, and 5λ + 3μ as 2. Let's solve them. Let's solve lambda is equal to 1 - 2μ over here. That is, this gives you 5λ. This is lambda is 1 minus 2 mu. 5 times 1 minus 2 mu plus 3 mu gives you 2. That is minus 10 mu plus 3 mu minus 7 mu. 7 mu is equal to 3. Mu is equal to 3 by 7. Mu is your, okay, this is minus 1, 2, 5, 2 minus 4, 3, 1 minus 2, 2. Determinant vanishes. And we must have this third plane must be linear combination of these two. That is, this is equal to lambda times minus 1, 2, 5 plus mu times 2 minus 4, 3. That means we have minus lambda plus 2 mu is equal to 1. 2 lambda minus 4 mu is minus 2. And 5 lambda plus 3 mu is equal to 2. We replace lambda over here as 2 mu. Okay, this is 2 mu minus 1. That means it is 13 mu is equal to 7. That means mu is 7 by 13. And lambda must be 2 mu minus 1. That is 14 by 13 minus 1. 1 by 13. Okay, that means this row will be 1 by 13 times of this row plus 7 by 13 times of second row. R3 is 1 by 13 times of row 1 plus 7 by 13 times of row 2. This must be the relationship between these B1, B2, B3 as well, for the case that third plane passes through the line of intersection of the two planes. Hence you get relationship between B1, B2, B3 as B3 must be 1 by 13 B1 plus 7 by 13 B2. This itself is a question. But in this case, it asks for another set of system, that is say set A, option A. It says the system is 1, 2, 3, 0, 4, 5, 1, 2, 6, same X, Y, Z, X is equal to same B, B1, B2, B3, B, X, and you have this as new matrix A1. It says if B1, B2, B3 belongs to this set, whereas B3 has this relationship between B1 and B2, whether this system has a unique at least one solution or not. Let's compute the determinant of coefficient matrix, determinant of A1. It comes out to be 1, 24 minus 10, that is 14, plus 10 minus 12, minus 2, it comes out to be 12. Clearly it is non-zero, it has a unique solution for all values of B1, B2, B3, that means this has a unique solution. Hence our solution B. Second is you have system 1, 1, 3, 5, 2, 6, and minus 2, minus 1, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, minus 3. Unknown matrix X, Y, Z, and right hand side matrix B1, B2, B3. Again, let's compute the determinant of this A2 matrix. Determinant of A2 matrix will be minus 6 plus 6, 0, minus 15 plus 12, minus 3, plus 3 times minus 5 plus 4, minus 1. It is coming out to be 0. Now, this is the case when we have coefficient matrix determinant is 0, but it could have solution, that is, it has infinitely many solutions. That means in the similar manner, if we have relation between B3, B1, B2 as this, that means we must have the same relationship between row 1, row 2, row 3 as this only. That means we must check whether this third row, that is minus 2, minus 1, minus 3, is it 1 by 13 of first row, that is 1, 1, 3, plus 7 by 13 of second row. If this relation holds, that means this is the case of infinitely many solution again, that is 5, 2, 6. And as you can see, first element over here is 1 by 13 and over here it is 14 by 13. 1 by 13 add up to 35 by 13. Clearly, this first element is not same as minus 2. It comes out to be 36 by 13, which is not minus 2. Hence, this has no solution. There is no possibility of infinitesimal solution option B. For option C, again, we need to check for this system minus 1, 2, minus 5, 2, minus 4, 10, 1, minus 2, 5, along with x, y, z, unknown matrix and right-hand matrix B1, B2, B3. Again, we need to find the denominator of that coefficient matrix A3. Let's say this is A3. This will be minus 1 times minus 20 plus 20 is 0. Then we have minus 2 times 10 minus 10 again 0. And minus 5 times minus 4 plus 4 0. It is again coming out to be 0. It could be, that means it could be either no solution case or it could have infinitely many solutions. Infinitely many solutions. Again, we need to check this again. That is, we have the relation between V1, V2, B3 as B3 was, that is, row 3 is 1/13th of row 1, 7/13th of row 2. Let's check that case in, over in this coefficient matrix. That is 1 minus 2, 5 as 1 by 13 of row 1, that is minus 1, 2 minus 5 plus 7 by 13 of row 2, that is 2 minus 4, 10. If this relation holds, this system has infinitely many solutions. If this relation won't hold, this system has no solution. Now, first element will be minus 1 by 13 plus 14 by 13, which is 1, okay? This is 1. Next element is 2 by 13, 2 by 13 and minus 28 by 13. That is minus 26 by 13, minus 2 also. This is also minus 2. Third one is minus 5 by 13, minus 5 by 13 and 70 by 13. That will be 65 by 13, but it is not. Minus 5 by 13 plus 70 by 13. 65 by 13. Now this relation holds in C case. That means it has infinitely many solution over here. Minus 1, 2, minus 5, 2, minus 4, 10, 1, minus 2, 5. Need to check row 3, that is this row, is 1 by 13. Row 3 is 1 by 13 of this row. 1 minus 2, 5 is negative. That means this third plane is also linear combination of these two. This third plane is also, this is negative of this, this is negative of this, this is negative of this. And in this case it holds, and B3 is 1/13th of row 1. This is double of this. This is double of this, this is double of this. But over here this plane is double of this expression. That means this is double of this. Row 2 is double of this row 3, clearly. That means, and similarly this is negative of this. Means if B1, B2, B3 are different, then this system only holds if B1, B2, B3 are 0. If B1, B2, B3 are 0, but that is not the case. That is not the case. Hence it has no solution again. It won't hold for every set of values of set S. And last is D is 1, 2, 5, 2, 0, 3, and 1, 4, minus 5. We have X, Y, Z, and B1, B2, B3 again. And this is, let's say, coefficient matrix A3. A3 determinant will be minus 12, minus 2 times, minus 10, minus 3, minus 13, plus 5 times 8, 40. It comes out to be 26 minus 12, 54. it is again not zero. This is the case of unique solution again. This is the case of unique solution again. Hence the answer key for the question is A and D. Now look at the second question. Okay. Now it says let P be a matrix of order 3 by 3 such that all the entries in P are from the set minus 1, 0 and 1. Then the maximum possible value of the determinant of P is, it is again from 2018 advanced paper. Let P be a matrix of order 3 by 3 such that all the entries in P are from the set minus 1, 0, 1. Then you need to find the maximum value of the determinant P, determinant of P. It says P be a matrix of order 3 by 3. Let's say it is A1, A2, A3, A4, A5, A6, A7, A8, A9. Further, it says all these AIs belongs to the set minus 1, 0 and 1. We need to find the maximum value of the determinant that P can take. Let's compute the determinant of P. It will be A1, A5, A9 minus A6, A8. Minus A2, A4, A9, minus A6, A7, plus A3, A4, A8, minus A5, A7. This will be A1, A5, A9, plus A2, A6, A7, plus A3, A4, A8 minus, this will be A1, A6, A8 plus A2, A4, A9, A2, A4, A9 plus A3, A5, A7. That is, this determinant has six terms, each term has a three factors over here. And each of these AIs belongs to this set. Each of these AIs belong to this set. Hence, you can say for each of these triplets, that is AI, AJ, AK, where each of them belongs to this set, magnitude will be maximum of 1. That is, it could be, this product will be either 1 or 0 or minus 1. Maximum will be 1. Now, for maximum value of determinant P, that is for maximum value of this mod determinant P, we must have, this must be 1, this must be 1, this must be 1. This must be minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. Hence, maximum possible determinant will be, P will be 6. Now, let's see whether this is possible or not. Maximum will be 6. Now, for that, we need, if the, let's say this is A, this is B, this is C, let's say this is X, this is Y, this is Z. For maximum to be 6, we must have A equals B equals C must be 1, and X equals Y equals Z must be equal to minus 1. But this is not possible, as if we product ABC, that is A, B, C, we get product of all the 9 elements, that is A1, A2, A3, A4, A5, A6, A7, A8, A9. Hence, and this, in this case, it will be 1. That means this 1 is of value of product of A2, A1 to A9. In the similar manner, what is the product of XYZ? In this case, X, Y, Z, which is also product of the same 9 elements. But in this case, if this, these 3 are minus 1, this will be minus 1. Which contradicts, that is maximum value of determinant P cannot be 6. Let's take the case when determinant maximum value P becomes 5. Now for determinant to be 5, maximum value to be 5, there are various permutations possible. That is either ABC, all of them are 1, ABC, all of them are 1, and could be X and Y minus 1, X and Y minus 1, and let's say Z is 0, Z is 0. That is, this product comes out to be 0. And there are many other permutations possible. Now, if all these 3 are 1, all these 3 are 1, and let's say Z is 0, in that case Z is 0, that means either A3, A5 or A7 must be 0. This implies either A3 or A5 or A7 must be 0. Either of these 3 must be 0. if either A3 or A5 or A7 is 0, that means these three elements also come in different other expression. A3 is over here, A5 is over here, A7 is over here. That means at least one of them also 0. This implies at least A or B or C must also be 0. That means at least B or C must be 0. That means this is not the possible. That is, all these three will be 1 and these two will be minus 1 and this is 0. That means maximum determinant possible is also not 5. Now let's take the case when maximum determinant possible is 5. Now 4. Now for this to be 4, two of them must be 2. That is, let's say A equals B is 2, 1 each, C 0, and two of them must be minus 1. And let's say Z is 0. Now, if that is possible or not, let's take an example. Let us take an example. That is, if we let A1 as 1, let's make a matrix A1 as 1, and we try to make the cofactor of that as also positive. That is, if we take this element as 1, this element as 1, 1, 1, 1, and these two product must be minus 1. Let's say this is minus 1, this is 1. Now, till now, we have determinant value as 2. Now, let's take this as minus 1, so that we have same change over here, that is 1. And let's say this is minus 1, this is minus 1. Again, on the same scenario, we have already have 1 into 2. Again, we have 1 into 2. Now, we could place any element over here, A3, that is either minus 1 or 0 or 1, but this cofactor of A3 will be 0. Hence, it won't matter whether A3 is 0 or 1 or minus 1. Hence, we get 4. That is, 4 is the maximum possibility, neither 5 nor 6. That is the answer key. That is, maximum value of the determinant is 4. Okay, let's look at the next question. It says, which of the following is not a square of a 3x3 matrix with real entries? Which of the following is not a square of a 3x3 matrix with real entries? That is, we need to find from whether any of these option is square of a matrix with real entries or not. Okay. Is A option 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. There is no need to check whether this is a square of a matrix with real entries or not, because this is just an identity matrix which is square of identity itself. Hence, this is not the answer. It can be expressed as square of the matrix with integer entries with the real entries B. It is 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 minus 1. Now, let's say this is matrix A. Now, if this can be expressed as square of a matrix with real entries, that is, if it is P square with each Pij belongs to R, that means determinant of P must be real. Determinant of P must be real. Hence, determinant of A must be determinant of P square. And as determinant P is a real quantity, this must be greater than or equal to 0. Now let's compute determinant of A. Determinant of A is coming out to be minus 1. Hence, for this to happen, determinant of P must be complex, which is not the possibility. Hence, this cannot be expressed as P square. A cannot be expressed as P square. Hence, B is your choice. Further, C. For C, we have entries as 1, 0, 0, 0, minus 1, 0. 0, 0, minus 1. Let's again take this A matrix as square of a matrix P, where P again has real entries. Okay. Now, let's find the determinant of A. Determinant of A simplifies to 1. Hence, we cannot comment on it because it is a positive quantity. So we cannot say whether P exists or not, because in this case, we have determinant of P is positive determinant of P is either positive or negative, but determinant of P square must be positive, but determinant of A is negative, hence this is not the possibility. But over here, determinant of P square is positive, as well as determinant of A is positive, hence we cannot say whether P square exists or not. Let's take the case, let's say 1, 0, 0, 0, minus 1, 0, 0, 0, minus 1. Let's make a matrix P as 1, 0, 0, 0, 0. Let's say this is A, B, C, D. And let's square it. A, B, C, D are reals. A, B, C, D belongs to reals. And that means it will be 1, 0, 0, 0, A, B, 0, C, D. 1, 0, 0, 0, A, B, 0, C, D. It will be 1, 0, 0, 0. It will be A square plus BC, AB plus BD, CD CA plus DC, and CB plus D square. Now let's compare this matrix with this matrix. We have four equations in four unknowns. That is A square plus BC is equal to minus 1, B common, A plus D must be equal to 0. Again, we have C common, A plus D must be equal to 0, and BC plus D square equated to minus 1. These are four equations in four unknowns. Now, let's take the case when this vanishes, that is AB into A plus D is 0. Now, in this case, if B is 0, then from this equation, A square comes out to be minus 1, hence A becomes imaginary, which is not the possibility, which we won't take. Now, let's take the case when A plus D is 0. A plus D is 0. When A plus D is 0, these two equation holds. When A plus D is 0, let's take when the case A is 0, D is 0. Let's take a particular case when A is 0, D is 0. When A is 0, D is 0, further these two equation will become, when A is 0, D is 0, these two equation become BC is equal to minus 1. And that is a possibility when B is 1, C is minus 1, and you may take B as 2, C as minus 1 by 2. That means if we take matrix A, this matrix P as, that is matrix P as, let's say 1, 0, 0, 0, 0. We have taken A and D both as 0. We have taken A and D both as 0. And B and C are of opposite sign with one magnitude, that let's say B is 1, C is minus 1. And if you square this matrix, you get this matrix only. And all the entries over here are integers or are real numbers. Hence, C also is not the case. C is also not the solution, because this can be formed by squaring this matrix and with all real entries. Let's take case of D option. It says matrix D is minus 1, 0, 0, 0, minus 1, 0, 0, 0, minus 1. Okay. Now let's, if this is P square, again, let's check the determinant of this. Determinant of this is non-negative. Let's check determinant of this. Determinant of A is clearly minus 1. Hence, again, this is negative and cannot be determinant of P square. This is not possible with real entries in P. Hence, the answer key for the question is B and D. Now, let's come to the next question of this paper. Next question is, it says, for a real alpha, if the given system of linear equation has infinitely many solutions, then what is the value, possible value of 1 plus alpha square? For a real number alpha, if this system of linear equation has infinitely many solutions, then what is the value of 1 plus alpha square? It says, given a system 1 alpha alpha square, alpha 1 alpha, alpha square alpha 1, x, y, z, and 1 minus 1, 1. It says alpha is a real quantity, alpha is a real quantity, and this system has infinitely many solutions. The system has infinitely many solutions. what is the possible value of what is n plus alpha square. Now, for the system to have invariantly many solution, we must have determinant of this coefficient matrix must be 0. Let's take that determinant. Determinant of A must be 1 alpha alpha square, alpha 1 alpha, alpha square alpha 1. Determinant comes out to be 1 minus alpha square minus alpha, alpha minus alpha cube plus alpha square minus alpha square 0. This will be 1 minus alpha square, 1 minus alpha square. Hence, this will be 1 minus alpha square whole square. If it is 0, we must have alpha as either 1 or minus 1. As there are only two possible values of alpha, let's rewrite the system again. If alpha is 1, this whole matrix will be just 1. That is 1. Hence, you have the equation x plus y plus z. When alpha is 1, first equation becomes x plus y plus z as 1. Second equation becomes x plus y plus z as minus 1. And third becomes x plus y plus z as 1. These two coincides, and this is a parallel plane. That is, there are two planes which coincide, and there is a third plane which is parallel to first and third. Hence, clearly no solution. Alpha cannot be 1. Now let's take the case when alpha is minus 1. This first equation will become x minus y plus z as 1. Second equation becomes minus x plus y. Alpha is minus 1 over here, minus z equals minus 1. And third equation becomes x minus y plus z equals 1. Now, all these three planes are coincident. This equation is same as first equation. Hence, it is the case of infinitely many solution. Hence, answer is alpha is 1. Alpha is minus 1. Hence, this answer will be 1 minus 1 plus 1. That is 1. It is an integer type question of 2017 advance. Hence, answer is 1. Let's look at the next question. It says how many matrices of 3 by 3 with entries from 0, 1 and 2 for which the sum of the diagonal entries of M transpose M is 5. Okay. It is a mixed question that involves matrices determinant as well as permutation combination. Okay. It says how many 3 cross 3 matrices, let's say this is A, A1, A2, A3, A4, A5, A6, A7, A8, A9, 3 by 3 matrices. How many 3 by 3 matrices exist? So with entries all AIs belongs to 0, 1 or 2, such that sum of the diagonal entries of M transpose M. As you know, sum of the diagonal entries of any matrix is called trace. Now, trace of M transpose M is given to be equal to 5. Count of A, number of matrices A. This is the question. How many matrices exist such that trace of M transpose M is 5? Now, let's find trace of M transpose. This is M. We need to find M transpose M. Now, let's find M transpose M. That is, M transpose M will be, you have A1, A2, A3, A4, A5, A6, A7, A8, A9 times A1, A2, A3, A4, A5, A6, A7, A8, A9. Let's focus on diagonal elements only. That is, one element will be A1 square plus A4 square plus A7 square. 2 element will be A2 square plus A5 square plus A8 square. And 3 element will be element at third row, third column. It will be A3 square plus A6 square plus A9 square. And it says trace of this matrix is given to be equal to 5. That means we must have sum of these three, these elements will be 5, which makes this equation, that is a1 square plus a4 square plus a7 square plus a2 square plus a5 square plus a8 square plus a3 square plus a6 square plus a9 square is equal to 5. And it consists of all ai's from 1 to 9. That is, it says summation of ai square, I varying from 1 to 9, is 5. Now let's check the cases when sum of ai square, where ai's belongs to this set, is 5. That means let's make a case when there are, let's say, 5 ones and 4 zeros. There are case 1. If out of these 9 elements there are 4 zeros, there are 4 zeros, there are 4 zeros and 5 ones, and 5 ones. There are 4 zeros, 5 ones. Then we can say sum of these squares of these 9 elements will be definitely 5 if there are 5 ones and 4 zeros. Now, how many matrices you can make using 4 zeros and 5 ones? How many matrices? This will be 9C4, or you may say 9C5. That will be 9 factorial, 9, 8, 7, 6 by 4, 3, 2, 1. 126. Now let's say second case possible is, if we drop 2 ones, if we drop 4 ones with 1, 2, that means we have 1, 2, 1, 1 and 7 zeros. 7 zeros, that makes sum of 7 square, 7 zeros as 0, 4 and 1, that means again 5. Hence this can be possible if there are 7 zeros placed in this, in these 7, 9 places. Let's place them 9C7. At 7 places we place 0. Now remaining 2 places, in one place we need 2, in another place we need 1, that is, you can permute it like 2C1. It will be 9 into 8 by 2, 36 into 2, 72. That means altogether we have 126 plus 172, that is 198 matrices possible for this case, that is option B. Now let's look at the next question of advance. It says there is a matrix P of 3 by 3 order, that is 3 minus 1 minus 2, 2 0 alpha, 3 minus 5 0, where alpha belongs to R, that is, and also says there is a matrix Q such that PQ is KI. And I is an identity matrix of order 3, and Q23 is given to be equal to minus k by 8. Determinant of Q is given to be equal to k square by 2. We need to predict what are the values of alpha and k over here, and determinant of P times adjoint of Q, and determinant of Q times adjoint of P over here. Now, this came in 2016 advance. Paper 1, it says matrix P is this, Q is a matrix such that PQ is KI, and Q23 is given to be minus K by 8, and determinant of Q is given to be equal to K square by 2. We need to find the values of alpha and K. It says matrix P is 3 minus 1 minus 2, 2 0 alpha, 3 minus 5 0, where alpha is some real number. Q matrix has entries Qij such that PQ is KI, PQ is KI, where K is real and it's non-zero real. K is non-zero real, I is identity matrix of order 3, you have further equation Q23 is minus K by 8, one relation is given this, and another relation is determinant of Q is given to be equal to K square by 2. Okay, we need to judge values of alpha and K and some more results. Now, Let's start with this result. That is, it says PQ is KI. This relation says PQ is KI, and as K is also non-zero real, K is non-zero real, we can say this is, implies P times 1 by K Q is I. And you can clearly say this matrix 1 by K times Q is P inverse. P inverse is 1 by K times Q. Okay. Okay, let's find two-third element of P inverse. As there is a mention of two-third element of Q over here, that is two-third element of Q divided by K. This is two-third element of Q divided by K is minus 1 by 8. Now let's find two-third element of P inverse. For that, we first find determinant of P. That is 3 times 5 alpha plus minus 3 alpha minus 2 times minus 10. This will be 15 minus 3, 12 alpha plus 20, or you may say 4 times 3 alpha plus 5. That is determinant of P. And we find two-third element of adjoint of P. Two-third element of adjoint of P. Adjoint of P, two-third element. That is C23. That is C32. That is C32. Third row, second column's cofactor, that is cofactor of this will be 3 alpha plus 4 with negative sign, minus of 3 alpha plus 4. That is two-third element of adjoint of P. Hence, that is the two-third element of P inverse will be C32 divided by this determinant. That is two-third element of adjoint of P divided by determinant of P is two-third element of P inverse, that is minus of 3 alpha plus 4 divided by determinant, that is 4 times 3 alpha plus 5 must be equal to 1kth of Q23. 1k by k times Q23 will be minus 1 by 8. Now let's simplify this equation. This will be 24 alpha plus 32 is equal to 12 alpha plus 5. That is 12 alpha comes out to be 5 minus 32. That is 20. This is minus 1 by 8. This is 4 times. Plus 20. This will be 12 alpha is equal to minus 12. That implies alpha is minus 1. Alpha comes out to be minus 1. Further, if alpha comes out to be minus 1, determinant of P was this quantity, that is 4 times 3 alpha plus 5. If alpha is minus 1, this comes out to be 8. Now let's use this equation, that is determinant of Q is equal to K square by 2, along with this equation. That is determinant of PQ will be determinant of KI, where I is of order 3, it has to be KQ. But it will be determinant of P, determinant of Q is K cube. Determinant of P we have already have 8. Determinant of Q is given in question as K square by 2 is equal to K cube, where K is non-zero implies K is equal to 4. K is 4. Alpha is minus 1, K is 4. These are the two parameters we have, values of the two parameters. Now let's go by the option. It's A option is definitely incorrect. It says alpha is 0. This implies A is incorrect. Now B option says 4 alpha minus K plus 8 is 0. 4 alpha, that is minus 4, minus 4 plus 8. This is true. C option says determinant of P times adjoint of Q is 2 to the power 9. Now determinant of adjoint P times adjoint of Q will be determinant of P, determinant of Q square. Now determinant of P was 8, and determinant of K is 64 by 2. Determinant of Q is also determinant of k is 16, but determinant of q is also 8. Determinant of q is also 8. That means it is equal to 8 square. Hence, that is 8 cube. That is 2 to the power 9. This is true. And what about D option? It says determinant of q time adjoint of p. Determinant of q time adjoint of p will be determinant of q and determinant of p square, which is also 8 cube. But this is not same as the given option, that is 2 to the power 13. This is false. As the answer key will be B and C. Now let's look at the next question. It says the total number of distinct x belonging to R for which the given determinant has value 10. It came in 2016 advanced paper. Says x belonging to R determinant x square 1 plus x cube 2x 4x square 1 plus 8x cube 3x 9x square 1 plus 27x cube determinant values given to be equal to 10. You need to find the number of distinct x belonging to R. Number of distinct x belonging to R, that is the question. Now you can clearly split this third column, hence you can write this determinant as sum of two determinants, as this will be equal to x 2x 3x, first column, second column intact as x square 4x square 9x square 1 1 1 plus x square x cube 2x 4x square 8x cube 3x 9x square 27x cube. Now let's simplify this determinant. Let's take x common, x square over here common. That means x cube times, it will be 1 1 1 2 4 1 and 3 9 1 plus, let's take x common from this, x square common from this, x common from this, that is it will be x square x cube x 6 will be 1 1 1 2 4 8 3 9 27. Okay, 2, let's check 2 common, 3 common, this will be 6 times, this is 1, this will be 2 4 1 3 9 1 1 1 1 2 4 1 3 9 1 1 1 1 2 4 1 3 9. These two determinants are the same. This is x cube plus 6x6. We make this as x cube 1 1 1 1 2 4 1 3 9. They are same. That means it is x cube plus 6x6 times. This is both of them are Vandermonde. That is, this will be 1 minus, this is 1 1 1. 1 minus 2, 2 minus 3. 3 minus 1, this is minus 1 times minus 1 times 2, that is 2x cube plus 6x6 is given to be equal to 10. Hence the equation becomes, you have 6x6, finally you have the equation 6x6 plus x cube minus 5 is equal to 0. You can split middle term like this, 6x6, and you may write it as 6x cube minus 5x cube minus 5. This will be 6x cube x cube plus 1 minus 5x cube plus 1. Hence x cube will be either 5 by 6 or minus 1. Hence x is cube root of 5 by 6 as one real value, and cube root of minus 1 as another real value, which is minus 1. That is, there are two distinct real x belonging to this R, which satisfies this equation. Hence there are two solutions. Let's come to next question. It is of advanced 2016 paper 2. It says matrix P is given to you,
I is identity matrix of order 3. Q is another matrix which satisfies this equation, that is P to the power 50 minus Q is identity matrix. And we need to find the Q31 plus Q32 by Q21. Let's look at this on board. It says P matrix is 100 410 16 4 1. Q is some another matrix with elements Qij, which satisfies P to the power 50 minus Q is identity matrix, and we need to find what is the value of Q31 plus Q32 by Q21. This we need to evaluate. That is, we need to evaluate matrix Q from this matrix P. We can write this Q as P to the power 50 minus I. That we must focus on this P to the power 50. That is 50th power of this matrix P. Let's write this matrix P as 100 010 001 plus 000 400 1640. I've extracted identity matrix from P. That is, this is I plus your X. This is, let's say, X matrix. Now let's compute P to the power 50. For finding P to the power 50, we must have I plus X whole to the power 50. And as this is sum of I and X which commutes each other, that is, I is commuted with, that means this will be 50C0 I 50, that is I, plus 50C1 X plus 50C2 X square using binomial theorem, 50C3 X cube, and so on and so forth till 50C50 X to the power 50. Now let's compute powers of X. It is low triangular. This is the scenario. That means let's find X square. X square will be 000 400 1640 to be multiplied by the same, that is 000 400 1640. Now this is 000. This will be 000 1640 1600. Okay, now let's find X cube. This will be 000 000 1600 times X square, that is 000 400 1640. This will be 000 000 000 000 null matrix. This is null matrix, hence all other powers, further powers will be 0. Hence this reduces to I plus 50x plus 50 times 49 by 2 x square. And P to the power 50 is this, P to the power 50 minus I will be Q. Hence Q will be nothing but this. This is the matrix Q. That is, Q matrix will be now, that means Q matrix will be P to the power 50 minus I, hence which is equal to, this is Q. That is, Q will be 50 times your matrix X. X was 000 400 1640. This is, and 50 times 49, that is, let's say 25 times 49 times X square. X square was 000 000 1600. This is Q matrix, and we need to find Q31 plus Q32 by Q21. Let's compute these three elements. Q31 will be third row, first column. Third row, first column, 50 into 16 plus 25 into 49 times 16. Q32 will be third row, second column, 50 into 4 plus 25 into 49 times 0. And Q21 will be second row, first column, 50 into 4 plus 25 into 49 into 0. That is this. We need to find sum of these two divided by this. That is, we have 50 times 16 plus 25 times 49 times 16 plus 50 times 4 whole divided by t times 4. This is what is asked in the question. Now let's cut 50. That is 8. Let's cut 4 also. This is 4, 2, 1. Now we are left with 4 plus 98 plus 1. Answer will be 4 plus 98 plus 1, that is 103. 103 is your B option. That is the official answer, that is B. Now let's check next question. It is again a system of equation, but this time it has two variables only. That is, it says A, lambda and mu belongs to R, and given the two equation in two unknowns, we need to predict whether it has infinitely many, unique or no solution depending on parameters A, lambda and mu. It says A, lambda, mu belonging to R, and system is Ax plus 2y equals lambda, 3x minus 2y equals mu. Now clearly these are just lines, line 1, line 2, and we go by your matrix Cramer's rule. That is, if these two lines has unique solution, this must cut at a point. These two lines have no solution if they are parallel, and infinitely many solution if they are coincident. That is, for unique solution we must have, determinant A 2, 3 minus 2 must not be equal to 0. That means it will be minus 2A minus 6 must not be equal to 0, that is A must not be equal to minus 3 for unique solution. For the case when there is these represents two parallel lines, that is there are infinitely many solutions, the coefficient must be proportionate. That means A by 3 must be 2 by minus 2, slopes are same, but must not be equal to lambda by mu. Now this says A is minus 3 and lambda is not equal to minus mu, that is lambda plus mu is not equal to 0. That is, lambda plus mu is not equal to 0 and a is minus 3 makes system inconsistent, that is at no solution. System has no solution, and for infinitely many solutions, that is the system has all possible values of x, y lying on this line, that is these two lines must coincide, that is a by 3 must be same as 2 by minus 2, must be same as lambda by mu. That says a is minus 3 and lambda is minus mu. That is lambda plus mu must be 0. Now that is, it is options B says A is not equal to minus 3, system has unique solution, which is true. And if lambda plus mu is 0, your system has infinitely many solution if A is minus 3, true. And if lambda plus mu is non-zero and A is still minus 3, it has no solution. That is B, C, D. This is given in B. This thing is given in C and this thing is given in D as the option. It is fairly simple question. Now this one is from Advanced 2015. It says there are two matrices X and Y, 3 by 3 matrices, non-zero, and they are skew symmetric matrices. Whereas Z is another 3 by 3 non-zero symmetric matrix, and we need to find which of the following options represents skew symmetric matrix. We need to go by option by option. Let's do it on board. That is, information given over here is X and Y are non-zero 3 cross 3 symmetric matrices, skew symmetric matrices. Further, Z is non-zero 3 by 3 symmetric matrix. Let's write in short SSM, this SSM. And we need to check which of the following is or are SSM. Which of the following is or are SSM. Now A option says, let's say matrix A is y cube z4 minus z4 y cube. We need to check whether this is symmetric or skew symmetric or none. Now, definition of skew symmetric matrices is accordingly x transpose. According to skew symmetric matrix, x transpose must be minus x, y transpose must be minus y, and z transpose must be z, as it is symmetric matrix. So let's take a transpose over here, y cube z4 minus z4 y cube whole transpose. This will be z transpose. We can distribute transpose on the sum or difference of the two matrices. This will be y cube z4 whole transpose minus z4 y cube whole transpose. And transpose on product will be distributive in reverse manner. This will be z4 transpose y cube transpose minus y cube transpose z4 z to the power 4 transpose. This will be z transpose to the power 4. Z transpose is z, that means it is z4. Y transpose cube will be minus y whole cube minus, this will be minus y cube, this will be z to the power 4. You may write it as minus of z4 y cube plus y cube z4. Y cube z4, and this is clearly the same matrix A. As addition is commutative, you can say y cube z4 minus of z4 y cube, which is A. Hence, clearly A is symmetric matrix. A is a symmetric matrix. Now, let's check for B. B is, B matrix over here is x to the power 44 plus y to the power 44. Now, x is a skew symmetric matrix, but this 44, that is even power of this skew symmetric matrix, is a symmetric matrix. That means clearly B transpose will be B, as x and y both skew symmetric, but having even power, B transpose will be B. That is, B is also a symmetric matrix. That implies B is also a symmetric matrix. Let's check for C. C is C, let's take it as C matrix only. X to the power 4 z cube minus z cube x4. Now let's check for C transpose. X4 z cube minus z cube x4 whole transpose. That will be z transpose cube x transpose 4 minus x transpose 4 z transpose cube. This will be z cube, x transpose is minus x to the power 4 will be x to the power 4 minus x transpose minus x, x to the power 4 z cube. And that is clearly negative of C. That implies C is skew symmetric matrix. C is a skew symmetric matrix. And last option D is x to the power 23 plus y to the power 23, x to the power 23 plus y raised to the power 23. And clearly x and y are skew symmetric matrix with e odd power this time. Hence x to the power 23 transpose will be minus x to the power 23. That implies D transpose will be minus D. Hence D is a skew symmetric matrix. And we need to find which of the following options are skew symmetric matrices. That means C and D are correct ones as the answer key for this paper, for this question. Now let's look at the next question of 2015 advance. It says of determinant, it says there is a determinant with parameter alpha in left hand side and it is equated to minus 648 alpha. We need to find the possible value of alpha. It says determinant of 1 plus alpha whole square, 1 plus 2 alpha whole square, 1 plus 3 alpha whole square, 2 plus alpha whole square, 2 plus 2 alpha whole square, 2 plus 3 alpha whole square, 3 plus alpha whole square, 3 plus 2 alpha whole square, 3 plus 3 alpha whole square is given to be equal to minus 648 alpha. We need to find the values of alpha which this equation satisfies. Now let's simplify this determinant. This will be 1 plus 2 alpha plus alpha square plus 1 plus 4 alpha plus 4 alpha square, 1 plus 6 alpha plus 9 alpha square, 4
plus 4 alpha plus alpha square. This will be 4 plus 8 alpha plus 4 alpha square. 4 plus 12 alpha plus 9 alpha square. And the last row will be 9 plus 6 alpha plus alpha square. 9 plus 12 alpha plus 4 alpha square. 9 plus 18 alpha plus 9 alpha square. Now let's try to split this determinant as product of two determinants using standard row by column multiplication, matrix multiplication. Let's write 1 over here. Okay, let's say alpha over here, alpha square over here, and we write 1, 2, 1. Let's write 2 over here, 1, 1. Okay, now if this is fixed, product of these three elements with these three elements gives you this element. Okay, now let's write, if these three are fixed, we can guess these three elements at these three positions. That is, product of these three with these three, I need this. That is 1, 1. For 4 alpha, let's write over here 2. For 4 alpha square, let's write over here 4. Okay, similar manner, let's say these three are fixed, we write over here 1. 3 and 9 over here. Obviously, many other permutation can be possible. Now, let's write second row will be, if this row is fixed, let's write this row as these three elements only, that is 4, 4 alpha, alpha square. And let's check whether this element came or not, that is 4 plus 8 alpha plus 4 alpha square, this is true. 4 plus 12 alpha plus 9 alpha square, this is also true. Hence, similarly, the last row will be 9, 6 alpha and alpha square only. Let's check this element, that is 9 plus 12 alpha plus 4 alpha square. 9 plus 18 alpha plus 9 alpha square. Done. Okay, let's take alpha common from here, alpha square common from here. Let's take 2 again common from here. Okay, that is, this will be 2 alpha cube determinant, it will be 1, 1, 1, over here it will be 4, 2, 1, this will be 9, 3, 1, times, we have 1, 1, 1, 1, 2, 3, 1, 4, 9, 1, 1, 1, 1, 2, 4, 1, 3, 9, 1, 1, 1, 1, 2, 4, 1, 3, 9, okay, now, these two determinants are same. If we interchange these two rows, these two columns, I'll get the same determinant. Hence, this will be minus 2 alpha cube, minus 2 alpha cube, and determinant 1, 1, 1, 1, 2, 4, 1, 3, 9, whole square. This will be minus 2 alpha cube. We have 1 minus 2, 2 minus 3, 3 minus 1, whole square. It is again Van der Waal determinant. This will be now minus 1. This is also minus 1. This is 2. 4. That is minus 8 alpha cube. This determinant simplifies to minus 8 alpha cube. Hence, you can say minus 8 alpha cubes is equal to minus 648 alpha. That implies alpha is either 0 or alpha square is 81. That is, alpha is plus or minus 9. There are three possible set of values of alpha: 0, 9 and minus 9. But of these, only 2 are given in options B and C. In options B and C, 0 is not given, but alpha can take 0 also. That is, answer key for this question is B and C, as you can see in official answer key. Let's look at the next question of 2014 advance. It says M and N be 2 3 cross 3 matrices with Mn is equal to Nm. That is, they commute each other. And further it says M is not N square, and further M square is N4. M square is equal to N to the power 4. We need to find the correct option. Which of the following option is correct? Now, as you can clearly say, this all the four options is based on matrix M square plus Mn square. M square plus Mn square. C is also talking about M square plus Mn square, and T is also talking about M square plus Mn square. Let's look at it on board. it says there are two matrices M and N, 3 by 3. They commute each other. M n is same as N m. Further, we have information M is not same as N square, and M square is same as N 4. These are the information given. And in all the option, there is a focus on M square plus M n square matrix. Its determinant based on this matrix only. Now let's start with this equation. This says M square minus N 4 is 0, and we can apply any identity on this A square and B square, as we have M n is same as N m. Else we cannot, because if they commute, we can apply any algebraic identities on matrices. Hence you can write over here, it gives me M plus N square, and it will be M minus N square. Product will be equal to 0. This product will be equal to 0. Now, as we have M is not N square, as we have M is not same as N square, that is M minus N square is non-zero matrix, it's a non-null matrix. We must have determinant of this matrix. This implies determinant of M plus N square must be 0. That is, this must be a singular matrix. As if determinant is non-zero, let's say go by contradiction, if M plus N square determinant is non-zero, if its determinant is non-zero, that means it is a non-singular matrix, hence its inverse exists. This implies M plus N square inverse exists. Its inverse exists, and if this inverse exists, if we post multiply by that inverse, M plus N square inverse, we get M minus N square is, if we post multiply this equation with M plus N square inverse, we get M minus N square is equal to 0. We get M minus N square equals 0, and that is M is equal to N square. But that contradicts. That is M is not equal to N square as question in as it is given, that M is not equal to N square. We must have determinant of M plus N square must be 0. Hence this implies determinant of M plus N square must vanish. And one option in this question is, we need to find determinant of M square plus M N square. We need to comment on determinant of M square plus M N square. We can say this is determinant of M times determinant of M plus N square. We can't say what is the determinant value of M, but determinant of M plus N square comes out to be 0, implies determinant of M square plus M N square must be 0. Determinant of M square plus M N square must be 0. That means this says A option is true. But clearly that contradicts option C. That implies C option is definitely incorrect, because C option says determinant of M square plus M N square is greater than or equal to 1. A and C are contradictory options. Now let's check for the another option. Further, it says there exists a 3 cross 3 non-zero matrix U such that M square plus M N square times U is null matrix. Now let's focus on this. That is, from this equation we have M minus N square and M plus N square. Let's write M plus N square over here. M plus N square, M minus N square is equal to null. Now if we multiply by M both sides, we get M square plus M N square. We pre-multiply by M. M square plus M N square times M minus N square is equal to null. And this, if we consider this matrix as U matrix, as in given option, if we consider this matrix as U matrix, it is definitely 3 by 3 matrix, as M and N are of 3 by 3 matrices. And clearly, if M is not equal to N square, this is non-null matrix. This is a non-null matrix, 3 by 3 matrix, such that product of these two matrices comes out to be 0, which is as per the option B. This is clearly true. And as B is true, D is false. This implies D is false. D is again contradictory. It says for any U for which this is equal to 0, for any U of 3 by 3 matrix for which this is equal to 0, your U matrix is 0. But over here U is non-zero. Hence B and D are contradictory option. B contradicts D. Hence the answer key for the question is A and B. Let's look at the next question of this paper. Now this advanced papers. It is of again 2014 advanced paper 1. It says M be a 2 cross 2 symmetric matrix with integer entries
and M is invertible. And we need to comment on, if M is invertible, which of the following options is there are correct? Now again, let's look at this on board. It says M be a 2 cross 2 symmetric matrix. M be a 2 cross 2 symmetric matrix and M is invertible. M is invertible. That means determinant of M must be non-zero. That is, M is non-singular. Let's take M as A, B, B. It is symmetric matrix, hence symmetric about diagonal. And let's say C or D. Let's say A, B, B, C. And let's go option by option. It says first column of M, let's say this is row 1, this is row 2, this is column 1, this one is column 2. It says first column of M is the transpose of second row of M. First column of M is transpose of second row of M, R2 transpose, that is BC transpose, that is BC. R2 transpose. Now, if these two are equal, that implies A is equal to B and B is equal to C. That is, all entries of this matrix will be same. That is, if all entries are same, determinant is non-zero is not possible. Determinant is definitely zero. This implies determinant of M will be zero and M is not invertible. Hence, A is incorrect, definitely. A is incorrect. B says second row of M, that is over here, it is BC, is transpose of the first column, which is one and the same thing as A, transpose of the first column, that is AB. Again, all this, in this case also, ABC are same, and determinant of M is again zero. C, M is a diagonal matrix with non-zero entries in the main diagonal. M is a diagonal matrix with non-zero entries in the main diagonal. If M is a diagonal matrix, we must have, for M to be a diagonal matrix, M must be in the form of 0, 0, AC. And it says diagonal entries are non-zero. A and C are not equal to 0. Clearly, in that case, determinant will be AC. Determinant of M will be AC, which is clearly non-zero. Which is clearly non-zero. Hence, invertible. C is the correct choice. And for D, it says the product of the entries in the main diagonal of M, that is AC, product of the entries in the main diagonals of M, that is AC, is not square of an integer. This is not a square of an integer. It is not I square. Hence, if it is not I square, it cannot be equal to B square also as well. It cannot be equal to B square. Hence, this is also invertible. That is also invertible. That is, D is also the correct choice. That means answer key for the question is C and D. Let's come to the next question. It says, for a 3 cross 3 matrices M and N, which of the following statements is or are not correct? Okay. And it is based on, again, matrices M and N. Is there are two matrices M and N of 3 by 3 order. Which of the following is not correct? A option is N transpose MN is SM or SSM accordingly. If M is SM or M is SSM. Okay. Now, let's take this as A. Let's find A transpose. A transpose will be N transpose MN whole transpose. That will be N transpose M transpose N. Now, this will be equal to A. This will be equal to A provided M transpose will be N. And this will be equal to minus of A if M transpose is equal to minus M. Hence, this option is clearly true. But we need to find which of the following is not correct. This is true, but let's check for the second option. Mn minus Nm is skew symmetric for all symmetric matrices M and N. Mn minus Nm transpose will be N transpose M transpose minus M transpose N transpose. And M and N are symmetric matrices. That means this will be Nm minus Mn. And that is negative of the input. That is negative of Mn minus Nm. That implies Mn minus Nm is SSM if M and N are symmetric. That is also true. But we need to select incorrect option. C, it says Mn is symmetric for all symmetric matrices M and N. Mn is symmetric for all symmetric matrices M and N. Let's take transpose of it. Mn transpose will be N transpose M transpose, and M and N are given to be symmetric. That is M transpose is M and N transpose is N. This will be Nm. This will be Nm, and we need to check whether it is symmetric or not. For it to be symmetric, we must have Nm must be same as Mn, but in general it is not true. This is not equal to C in general, because we can't say Mn commutes. Now this says Mn is symmetric for all symmetric matrices Mn, that means this is false. We need to select this. This is false. And last option is adjoint of M times adjoint of N is adjoint of Mn for all invertible matrices Mn. For all invertible matrices Mn, that is determinant of M is non-zero and determinant of N is also non-zero. Now let's link it with inverse. That is, if M inverse is your, okay, we have M inverse is 1 by determinant of M into adjoint of M. Hence adjoint of M will be considered as determinant M into M inverse. Adjoint of M will be considered as determinant of M times M inverse. Hence, if we find left hand side, this will be adjoint of M times adjoint of N will be determinant of M inverse times determinant of N times N inverse. That will be determinant of Mn times Nm whole inverse, as inverse also holds for from reverse order. That is Nm whole inverse. This will be adjoint of Nm. By the same definition, this denotes adjoint of Nm, and which in general is not equal to adjoint of Mn. Hence, this is also not correct, but we need to select this, because we need to find incorrect options. That is, answer key for the question is C and D. That is given over here, official answer key. Now, this came in Advanced 2013. It says omega be a complex cube root of unity, and it is not one non-real complex cube root of non-real imaginary complex cube root of unity. P is matrix Pij of order n by n. Further, it says Pij is omega to the power I plus j, and P square is not zero. Then values what n can take is omega not equal to 1 is complex cube root of unity. Complex cube root of unity. Further, it says P matrix is Pij of order n by n. Such that Pij is given to be equal to omega to the power I plus j. And P square is not null.
we need to find values of n from the given options, what n can take, what order is possible. Now, as the definition of Pij, Pij says Pij is omega to the power I plus j, which is equivalent to omega to the power j plus I, commutativity of addition. This will be equal to Pji. Pji. That means all ijth element of P will be jith element of P. That implies P transpose is P. P is a symmetric matrix. Now let's simplify P square. P square will be P times P, which is equivalent to P transpose. P times P is P transpose. P transpose. Now P transpose. Okay. Now let's find general element of P square. General element of P square. I square. IJth element of P square. This will be obtained by multiplying ith row of P and jth column of P transpose, which is equivalent to jth row of P. Ith row of P will consist of all the elements, ith row I of P. Let's write row I of P will be, this will be I1, omega to the power I plus 1, next will be omega to the power I plus 2, and this goes on till omega to the power I plus n. There are n columns. And jth column of P transpose is same as jth row of P will be omega j plus 1, omega j plus 2, omega j plus n. And we need to find the ijth element of P square, which will be summation of product of these elements. That is, it will be summation of omega to the power I plus k times omega to the power j plus k. K varies from 1 to n. This will be equal to summation k varies from 1 to n omega to the power I plus j plus 2k. Now let's further simplify that. This will be, let's take omega to the power I plus j common, and we are left with the GP with first term omega square and common ratio of omega square only. This will be omega square 1 minus omega square to the power number of term, that will be n, divided by 1 minus omega square. That is the ijth element of P square, general ijth element of P square is coming out to be omega to the power I plus j omega square, that is omega to the power I plus j plus 2, 1 minus omega square to the power n, omega to the power 2n, divided by 1 minus omega square. Now, as we have, omega is complex cube root of unity, powers of omega will be either omega or omega square for all powers, possible powers. Hence, this part cannot be 0. This part clearly will not be 0. For P square to be 0, if we consider P contradictory to this statement, if P square is 0, if and only if this part is 0, that is omega to the power 2n will be 0. Omega to the power 2n will be 1. Now, for what values of n, omega to the power 2n will be 1, if 2n is a multiple of 3. Which eventually is n is a multiple of 3. That means n, if n is multiple of 3, P square will be 0. P square is 0 if n is 3k, and will not be 0 if n is not 3k. And we want P square is non-zero for what values of n. Hence, from the given option, if n is not multiple of 3k, P square will be 0, which is B, C and D option. P square is non-zero for n is equal to 55, 58 and 56. B, C and D options. And it will be 0 for first option, that is 57. That is the official answer key, that is B, C and D. Thank you.